Welcome all my dear students to Sudharma's Physics Classroom. We are on the chapter Force and Pressure from CBSE Grade 8. And today's class, we are going to discuss the topic pressure. Okay, so in the previous videos, we discussed about the definition of force, the types of forces and the effects of forces. If you are watching this class for the first time, you can go ahead and watch the previous videos also so that you get the idea about the topics we discussed in the previous videos. So let's come into today's topic. It's pressure. So what is pressure and how do we define pressure? Pressure is defined as the force per area. So force acting on an object per unit area is defined as pressure, and pressure P is pressure is represented by the letter P, and pressure is equal to force by area. Okay, F is the force, amount of force acting on the object, and A is the area on which this force is acting. Okay, so when you apply more force on a larger area, we can see that area is coming in the denominator, right? If area, when area is in the denominator, we can say that the pressure is inversely proportional to area. More the area, less pressure. Less the area, more pressure. Okay, so that is the idea about pressure. So whatever force we are applying on an object, if you are applying that force on a smaller area, then the pressure is going to be large. And if you apply the same force on a larger area, then the pressure is going to be very less. Okay, because pressure is inversely proportional to area. Pressure is the force per unit area. Okay, now what is the unit of it? When you look at this equation, you can understand that the force is expressed in Newton and area is expressed in meter square, right? So the unit of pressure we get from this equation is Newton per meter square. Sometimes in some books you see that Newton meter raised to minus 2. This is nothing but Newton by meter square, okay? And the SI unit of pressure, see, every physical quantity will have SI unit. SI unit of pressure is Pascal. Pascal, and it is represented by Pa. Okay, so SI unit of pressure is Pascal. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton by 1 meter square. If a force of 1 Newton is applied on an object on an area of 1 meter square, we can say that the pressure is 1 Pascal. Now, how do we understand this in real life situation? What are the uses of the concept of pressure in our real life? Let's consider the example of a brick. We have the brick. The same brick is kept in two different ways. Will there be any difference in the pressure applied by this brick on the floor? We're going to understand that in through a numerical. Okay, now let's come to this school bag. The school bag, you know, school bags nowadays, it used to be very heavy, right? So how do you hold this school bag? If you hold it on your back, if you put it on your back, then if it is very heavy, there are chances for you to develop back pain. So maybe you have observed this, straps of the school bags are wide, very wide, because the complete weight of this bag, complete bag and books, everything is distributed over a larger area. Since force, the pressure is inversely proportional to area. For a given amount of force, if the area is larger, the pressure applied on our body is going to be smaller, because area is larger, the straps, the force applied spreads over a larger area. So we won't get that much pressure on our body. Now imagine the straps of the school bag. It's very thin. It's going to be very difficult to lift the school bag, and on our back, more and more pressure of the weight of the books will be applied. It's going to be a very difficult situation. Okay, now let's understand the example of that brick with the help of a numerical. We're going to apply the formula we have understood. Now question is, calculate the pressure exerted by a brick which applies a force of 2.5 Newton. Okay, the brick is applying a force of 2.5 Newton. When we have to consider two cases. It is placed upright on the soil, and when it is placed on its widest base. See, already in the previous picture I have shown you the same brick kept in different ways, right? So force applied is 2.5 Newton. We have force is equal to 2.5 Newton, and the dimensions of the bricks are 25 centimeter into 10 centimeter into 5 centimeter. That means length, width and height is given. Now let's consider the first case. How do we solve this? Or let's see whether there will be a difference of pressure in both the cases. When it is kept upright, right? So we can say area, first of all, let's calculate the area, the force is given, right? So when it is kept upright, the smaller portion will be in contact with the soil, right? So what are the smallest dimensions here? 10 centimeter and 5 centimeter. So area is equal to, see, whichever area comes in contact with the surface, that is what we have to consider here, okay? So that is 10 centimeter into 5 centimeter, that's going to be 50 centimeter square, and when we solve the numericals, we have to convert everything into SI unit. So we can say that 10 centimeter by 100 meter, right? So multiplied by 5 centimeter by 100, right? That will give you in meters. So when you divide by 100, you get the values in meter. So 50 by 100 square. So you will get 0.005 meter square. This is how we convert centimeter square into meter square. Now the pressure P is equal to force by area. Force is 2.5 Newton. Area is 0.005 meter square. So once you calculate this, you will get the value as 500 Pascal. So this is the first case when the brick is kept upright. Now, when the brick is placed by it on its widest base, that means we have to consider the area where the maximum dimensions are given. So area is equal to 25 by 100. I am directly substituting that here because I am converting that centimeter into meter. 25 by 100 meter into 10 by 100, because to convert centimeter into meter, we have to divide by 100. So 25 into 10 by 100 square, right? So this is going to be 0.025 meter square. This is the area which is in contact with the surface. You just see the values here. Initially, the area when the brick was kept upright, the area was 0.005. Now it is 0.025. Think which is more area and how it is related with pressure. So pressure is equal to force by area. Same force is applied because the weight, right? When you keep the brick, it's the weight of the object acting on the surface. So it is 2.5 Newton divided by 0.025 meter square. So this is going to be 2.5 by 0.025 meter square. So 100 Pascal. So what makes the difference here? When you keep the smaller area in contact with the surface, the pressure was more, right? The area is less, the pressure was more, that was 500 Pascal. Now, when you keep that more area in contact with the surface, then the pressure decreased. More the area, less pressure, okay? So this is how we apply that concept and the equation in the numerical. So you will be getting different types of numericals like this. So first you calculate the area, make sure everything is in SI unit, then calculate it, you will get the pressure in Pascal. Okay, so let's move on to some real life examples for the application of this concept. See, the knives used to have very sharp edges. What happens if the knife is having a very blunt edge? Okay, think about that. What happens? Its cutting will be very difficult, right? But how do we explain the concept of pressure here? When the area is very less, right? The contact, when you are cutting a vegetable, the knife edges are in contact with the vegetable. So the force we are applying, that is applied on a short or very small area, the pressure is getting increased, right? Pressure and force, pressure and area, they are inversely proportional. So less the area, more pressure. So for a given amount of force, more pressure will be applied on the surface and the cutting is going to be very easy. If it is blunt, then the surface on which we are applying the force, the area in contact with the surface is going to increase, then the pressure will decrease. So we will have to apply more force in that case if the edges are not sharp. Okay, so this is one of the important applications of pressure in real life. Now The tractors will have very wide wheels and they are rough also, right? So these tractors will move to the muddy field, right? So there are more, this vehicle itself is very heavy. So there is a chance for this vehicle to get submerged into the soil. And even when the vehicle is, if the vehicle is having a very thin wheel, what happens is the entire weight of the vehicle is applied over a larger area. If it is very thin, if it is, it's going to be applied on a smaller area, and the pressure is going to be very large, and this gets stuck into the soil. But if the tires are very wide, the force is applied over a very large area, the pressure applied on the surface is going to be reduced, and it makes it easy to move on those types of surfaces. Okay, so this is another example for application of pressure in real life. Many of you will be wearing shoes like this, right? The heeled shoes. So normally it is suggested not to wear shoes like this because our body weight is concentrated on the tip of this, right? It's a very small area. The pressure, when with our body weight, it's a force, right? The force is distributed over a smaller area, and the pressure exerted on our body, especially on our backbone, is going to be very large because its area is very less here. Okay, so more pressure will be exerted on our body. So that is why it is not suggested to wear these types of shoes. Normally we are suggested to wear flat surface shoes, right? Another example is the snow boot. Snow boots are very wider. Because if so imagine you are wearing this kind of a shoes and going to the snow, definitely you won't be able to walk properly. But if you wear shoes like this with wider bases, you will be easily able to move over the snow because your body weight is distributed over a larger area. Okay, because when weight is weight means it's a force. If it is distributed over a larger area, then the pressure is going to be less. More the area, less pressure. So you can easily walk over the snow. Now let's consider one more example in real life. This maybe on the railway tracks you might have seen this kind of concrete grids, right? Why that is kept there? What happens only if the tracks are there? You know, the train is itself is very heavy, right? Many compartments along with people inside it, right? So it's going to be very heavy. When the train is moving, the complete weight is applied on this tracks. If only these tracks are there, then definitely the train along with the track, there is more chance for it to get into the soil, right? Get stuck into the soil because it's very heavy. So large amount of force is applied over a smaller area, then the pressure is going to be very high. But if you have these kind of concrete girders, then what happens? The pressure is distributed, right? The force applied on that track, that is distributed over a larger area, then the pressure exerted on the surface we can reduce and help the train to move in a smooth manner. These are some of the real life examples where we have the concept of pressure is applied. You can think about different ways, different examples, what you see in your life, and compare and just relate that with the concept of pressure. Hope you understood today's discussion. And as a continuation of this, we just understood what is pressure and some of the real life examples, and much more interesting things are waiting for you. That's nothing but the pressure in fluids. These are the topics you have not learned till date, right? Because many applications we are going to understand in the coming sessions. Okay, so if you have not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get updates whenever I upload new videos. Okay, so read the textbook and understand. And another thing is you relate the concept with your real life things. Okay, then understanding will be much better. And practice the numericals. Okay, practice different types of questions. I will be discussing questions once a lot of numericals after we finish the chapter. So in the coming sessions, we will be discussing about pressure in fluids. And stay tuned for the next class. Thank you for watching. See you in the next class. Bye.